Okay, otakus, it's your tour guide here, and I'm gonna go over my comic haul, and all these books are from Half Price Books. We're gonna get right into it. I have about 31 books that I got at Half Price Books, and we'll go over what I paid for and over the books, and let me know what you think of the haul at the end of the video. So let's get into it. 8 items here. So the two, these two from Redman, I got a total of 20, what is that? 8 plus 16 is 24 items. 24 items plus the 3 I got from Redmond the day before, that's 27 plus 4 makes 31. So I got 31 comics and I spent $16.18. So what that works out to is about 54 cents per comic, and again, 54 cents per comic, that's so reasonable. Not a lot of these comics are in high grade. Actually, I would say they're all in high grade. It's just they're not, you know, they're in like the very fine range, most of them, the very good to very fine range. So they're like high mid-grade to high-grade comics for the most part. So we're going to start here with Superman number 14. And this is Ivan Reis' cover, Brian Michael Bendis' story. It's the first cameo appearances of Gold Lantern and Monster Boy. So I got this for a quarter. It's a key. Just happy to pick that up. It's not worth a lot. I think, you know, for this book, you probably wouldn't pick it up unless you were getting it for like undercover. And luckily I was able to get it for 25 cents, which is a really good bargain and deal. And again, it's a key. I like the cover. Getting more and more modern books. Especially in this haul, there's quite a few modern books. I'm starting with a lot of the modern stuff to begin with. All right, next we've got X-Men number 6. This is a cover by Lionel Francis Yu, and it's a Jonathan Hickman story. And this is a great Mystique cover. She's holding some guns there running. And it's, again, Lionel Francis Yu cover, beautiful cover. And this is a key because it's the origin of Nimrod, X-Men number 6. Again, pick this up for a quarter. Can't beat that. Can't beat it at all. It's a key. Again, not worth a lot. You know, just around cover price. Hopefully these things will go up when there's a, you know, when there's something movie related. Okay, so now next book is X-Men number 8, also from that Hickman, and this is also a Lionel Francis Yu cover. Beautiful cover. This is significant because it's the first cameo appearance of King Egg, a mutant that hatches from eggs. So great cover there as well. Again, picking up for 25 cents. Normally I wouldn't get these books, but when they're keys and they're for a quarter, you'd be a fool not to pick them up. So hopefully these will go up in value at some point. So this is another book that came out around that time. Classic X-Men. This was, you know, this is a newsstand edition from August 1988. So this around this time is when I kind of got into X-Men. It was around 1986 when I started really getting into X-Men, and I was reading these classic X-Men's, so this is a real nostalgic factor. This is a reprint of X-Men 118, which is the first appearance of Mariko Yashida. So yeah, it's a pretty cool issue. Sunfire's there. Of course, the original is the Byrne Claremont classic. So got this again. I got this for 50 cents half off. This is for 50 cents and it's a new stand edition. So again, it's not worth much. I think it's like, you know, $2, $3 comic, but it's a pretty clean copy. It's a new stand edition. And again, for me, it's the nostalgic factor. And this cover was drawn by Kerry Gamble. Okay, and now we're getting into more 80s stuff. This is Excalibur number one. And this is the first appearance of Widget and the first, you know, team story. It features, you know, Rachel Summers as Dark Phoenix. And it also features, you know, the team of Polaris, Nightcrawler, and others. But yeah, this one written by Claremont as well. Penciled by Alan Davis. This is a great cover by Alan Davis. And it's a number one issue. So again, it's a key. I picked it up for half off, which is 75 cents. Happy to do that. It's a $10 comic and it's a really clean copy. So this should come back high grade if it ever got slapped, but I would say it's like a 9-0, really clean copy. I got a stack of X-Factor books. Now, I read X-Factor. I had several issues of X-Factor. And of course, you know, when you read X-Men and you're reading something like The Inferno or you're reading some kind of crossover, it oftentimes crosses over storylines into X-Factor. So you're all constantly reading X-Factor just to keep up with the X-Men storylines. So we're going to go over all these books. It's a fat stack of, you know, X-Factor books. And most of these I got for half off. So it's got a 75 cent price. You know, it's got a 75 cent cover price. So that roughly translates to about, you know, whatever half of 75 is, like 37 cents or whatever. 37 cents for most of these books. Some of these books, as you get into the later ones, go up to a dollar. So it's and some of them were 25 cent books. So we'll get into all of that. This was half off. This was 37 cents. X-Factor number 8. This is a newsstand edition. It's a pretty beat up copy. It's got a lot of spine ticks. I would definitely put this at around like a 7-0, maybe a 6-5. But again, newsstand cover. This isn't necessarily worth all that much. It's not a big key, but it's Mark Silvestri on the cover and in the interior, and it's Louise Simonson story. So nice Silvestri art there. Beautiful. And this stuff is like just so nostalgic for me. Next, we've got issue number 9. Another great Silvestri cover. Interiors, Terry Schumacher. Again, Simonson's story. This isn't a particular key as well either, but it's a newsstand edition. It's got a large crease right here, as you can see. So this is a pretty beat up copy. I would say it's in like a 6-0, maybe even a 5-0. But yeah, aside from that crease, it's not so bad, aside from that crease. Okay, next is a big pickup. We've got the 25th anniversary. Now, I've always liked this cover. I had this on my wish list, and I was able to get two copies of this. They had two copies. So again, I got both of these for 37 cents each. So we've got the new stand edition, and this is a 7.5, I would say. Pretty decent. This one's a little better condition. The direct edition's a little better condition. This could go for like an 8.5. But two copies of 25th anniversary cover. And, Walter Simonson inked this cover and the interior. And that's just a really cool image of Cyclops. And this is the anniversary issue. It'd be cool to kind of collect all of these, but there's so many titles. It's at least getting the X-Men titles would be good. The X-Men, the Uncanny X-Men one has Wolverine kind of, he's kind of beat up and has, half of his mask off and whatnot. That cover is pretty cool too. I'll try to pick that up at some point. But yeah, happy to pick up the direct and the newsstand. Happy to have two copies in my collection now. Next, issue number 11. Where'd that one go? Here it is. Issue number 11. Issue number 11. Also paid, this one I paid, what'd I pay for this one? Yeah, I paid, so some of these have been rebagged. So I used some of the bags and put the more expensive comics into different bags. Some of the raw comics into bags. So they got kind of shuffled around, but I paid 37 cents for this one. It's a new stand edition. And again, it's Walter Simonson who did the cover and the interior. Just a great cover there. Cyclops. Next we have X-Factor number 12. This one, not a key issue. It's got Boom Boom on the cover. But remember Boom Boom, she's kind of like X-Factor or X-Men and X-Factors. She kind of is like a Dazzler type figure. She's kind of like a mixture between Dazzler and a Jubilee. This is a cool cover. Number 12 is a cool cover by Walter Simonson. Silvestri did the interiors on this one. And again, all of these are newsstand pickups. So that's kind of the cool thing about this haul. I was picking up newsstand copies for, 37 cents, 25 cents. And X-Factor. So I got this huge run of X-Factor now. I might have to complete it. This is a key. This is the sort of the apparent death of Warren. Angel gets his wings clipped in this one. He loses his wings and he apparently dies. He does come back later with the metal blade wings, and he comes back as, allied with Apocalypse. And he comes back as Archangel. It's pretty, the transformation is cool. I think this is one of those instances where, the old team X-Men look was kind of dated, and he just looked like an angel, and then they took a dark turn. But this is the issue. He loses his wings, and it's the apparent death, so it's a key. I believe it books at around $15. It's a pretty clean copy too. I would grade this at around an 8.5. nothing majorly wrong with the book. No creases or anything like that, just some round corners. No spine ticks. It's a pretty clean spine. So I would imagine with a clean and a press, this would bump the grade up to, again, around 8.5. Next is a big key. This is the second cover appearance of Apocalypse. It's the first team cover of the Horsemen of Apocalypse. And this is a great copy too. This is also a newsstand edition. It's a cover by Walter Simonson. This is also around $10. Sorry, so this is $10. This previous comic I showed is around $10 as well. This was a direct edition though. This one's a newsstand. Loving that Walter Simonson cover. Looks very nice. All right, next one is really a great, one of my favorite covers. When I was just getting into X-Men, Inferno came out and Silvestri was just killing it on X-Men. And so, this is the, again, this is Walter Simonson doing his thing. And just a beautiful, beautiful copy. This is a key as well. It's the origin and death of the Goblin Queen, or Madeline Pryor, the clone of Jane Summers. And Warren officially becomes, Beast coins the his name Archangel. So he officially becomes Archangel in this issue. Issue number 38. It's a pretty decent copy. I'd put it, it's a red cover, so it's gonna expose all the things wrong with the book, but it's got a pretty clean spine, again with the press and a clean. I think this could come back 8.5 very easily. I would put it in the 8.5 range. Could come back higher. All right, moving right along. So that was issue number 38. We've got issue number 39. This is a great cover. Also a Walter Simonson cover. Another newsstand edition there. Got the whole team along with the X-Men, some members of the X-Men there. You got Psylocke, Longshot, Dazzler. I mean, this was really, this is a continuation of that Inferno storyline. So, they've been fighting the creatures from hell. Okay, cool. So there's a miswrap there on the spine. There you can see the miswrap, and it's got some spine ticks, but overall I think even with a press and a clean, again I think we could get it up to an 8.5, maybe an 8.0, maybe it's around an 8.0. Love that cover. All right, the next cover is for Rob Liefeld fans. This is Rob Liefeld's first cover and interior work for Marvel, X Factor number 40. Now, I'm not a big Liefeld fan. I do have a lot of his comics, though. I have his New Mutants 98, his X-Force. Everybody had his X-Force, X-Force number one. But this is for, if you're a collector of Liefeld, this is definitely one you want to have in your collection. Again, his first cover and his first interior work. So pretty good haul, in my opinion. I spent, again, $16.18 on 31 books. And again, just this X-Factor haul is probably more than double in terms of the value I got And we got more books outside of this. So this is a X Factor number 42. This is an Art Adams cover. It's a cool Art Adams cover as well. This is from 1989. He did the interior on this one as well. Archangel is fighting Sabretooth, featuring the murderous Sabretooth. Lifehill cover, got this for a quarter as well. We also got this one for a quarter as well. This 53 is the issue where Cyclops proposes to Jean Grey. Now remember, he proposed to Jean Grey when they were fighting the Shi'ar, and that's when Jean kind of like, you know, sacrifices herself and she dies. And so Scott never gets to really follow through with the marriage proposal. He proposes to her, she says yes, but then she dies, and that's that. But then, you know, Jean Grey comes back, and in this issue, he proposes, but the catch is she actually rejects him. So it's not going anywhere, these two. They do eventually get married, but they kind of keep you hanging with the romance there. But great kiss shot. This would be a great addition to the couple's covers. But you've got a lot of people on the cover here. And this is a great cover by Terry Schumacher. Okay. Again, not in a rush to do that. So I got this for a quarter as well. Not very familiar with Brian Haberlin's work, but it's a pretty cool cover. And again, for a quarter, I think this book's at like $10. So I just thought, interesting first, first issue. The cover's pretty cool. And the story on this is, it's about social media influencers whose tattoos like can transport them to different realms and do magic. It's a pretty weird story, but I got it because it was a quarter. Again, it is booking at like $10. This one as well, this book's at $15. This is the Wicked plus the Divine. The Wicked plus the Divine. And it's a Kieran Gillen story. It's the cover art is by a guy named Jamie McKelvey. Not too familiar with this, but hopefully I did hear that this The Wicked and the Divine was optioned by Universal. So maybe we'll see some kind of movie or television series at some point. But first issue, I think it books at 15 and I paid a quarter for it. So I think so. This has been definitely my best haul of the year. I didn't get anything that, I mean, there are books here that aren't on my want list per se, but they're high valued books. And by the end, I think you'll agree that it was $16 well spent. Okay, so this is another just nostalgic buy for me. This is Eric Larson's The Savage Dragon, number one. Just a great cover by Eric Larson. And this still is still in in um, this serial is still running. So it's just amazing to think that Eric Larson has been doing this for almost going almost, he's been doing this for 25 years, almost as well, 20, what is that? This launched in 1993. So yeah, it's going on 20 years. Next year will be the 20th anniversary of The Savage Dragon. Just a cool cover. Eric Larson bringing the, oh, the, I was able to pick up some Jim Lee books. And that's the thing, about my haul. I'm always looking out for Jim Lee books. So rarely will you see me come back in a haul without at least one Jim Lee book. Generally, when I go out and I'm hunting for books, that's the first thing I'm looking for. And I actually found something that was really, first of all, I'm going to show you the back cover. So this is the variant cover. This issue comes in three variants. And this is the first of three variants. The variants were drawn by Rob Liefeld, Todd McFarlane, and Rick Valentino. So this cover here is by Liefeld, and this is called The Drag Queen. The Jolly Green Drag Queen. And a savage dragon, basically, dressed up in drag. And what this issue is, it's the splitting image. It's sort of images, I guess, they were trying to kind of do their take on, like, you know, Marvel Age or just some kind of preview book. And this was just really previewing what Image was about. And you can see here, you got all these great Image characters, right? Spawn, you got Savage Dragon, you've got, I'm drawing a blank on that guy's name. But Wildcats, and just a bunch of Image characters there. But on the side here, you've got characterization. So you've got Jim Lee right there, Todd McFarlane, Rob Liefeld. I think that's supposed to be Eric Larson. Again, Jim Valentino and Mark Silvestri. And then Will Portatio. That actually looks like Will Portatio. But yeah, it's I thought this was a really funny cover. I was deep into collecting in the 90s, as a lot of people my age were into comics probably were. And for me, it scratches that Jim Lee itch, because anytime Jim Lee's on a cover, you know, he's on the cover of Marvel Age 104, but this is another cover where he's Brainiac. Look, he's got the Brainiac. Todd's the like a hockey beat up hockey player. It's like everybody's got their little characterizations. Mark Silvestri, I guess, just a pretty boy. But for me, this is I love all these. I was collecting all these guys back in the day. I bought a lot of Image comics. Regret having done that, but that was what was hot back then. You picked up a Wizards magazine. Wizard was telling you to buy, you know, Spawn, and telling you to buy like Wet Works and all these Image titles. And that's what you did. And so just happy to have this copy. Again, it's the Jolly Green Drag Queen variant cover. I actually want the Spawn cover. It's called Spasm. The Spawn variant cover is actually the cooler one, but you know, this is, again, I found this. I paid a quarter for this as well. I had to get the sticker off. The sticker was stuck right on this cover here. I paid 25 cents for this. Money well spent. Love that investment. Now, this next cover, so this book I actually have, this is the book I have, but on the back, what I did was I got a second copy of, this is the polybagged copy. So it's still in the polybag here. And I've put the back, so I basically what I did is, this has my original comic that's out of the poly bag. this has the polybag version, and I just put the back cover there so it just looks like, you know, it's front and back. And you can see the great Jim Lee card here that comes with the polybag. So this is Wildcats number 4. I got picked this up for a quarter. I'm sure the card alone is worth more than that, but just a great great comic card by Jim Lee, the Grifter. And anyway, I forget their names. Okay, so that's one Jim. So I've got two, we went through two Jim Lee books. This one, you know, they dropped the price on this. They put this in the quarter bin finally, because I saw this, I wasn't gonna pay $2 for it, but when they put it in the quarter bin, I said, yeah, I'll pick it up now. So I got this for a quarter. It's a Justice League number 6, Jim Lee cover. Great cover of Darkseid and the Justice League bowing down to him. Just an amazing cover. So I've been meaning to get this, and now I finally add it to my collection. Again, it's not worth a lot. It's you know, right around cover price. So, but the art is amazing. It's another Jim Lee book in my collection. Now this next one, I paid. This one is one of the ones I paid $1.50 for. Half off of $2.99. Paid $1.50. This is finally, I got the All-Star Batman, the Batman cover. You know, I had this one, the Robin cover. And now I've added the Batman cover. So I was able to pick this up for $1.50. It's a pretty clean copy. It's got a few spine ticks, but overall presents well, and probably come back if I were to grade it like an 8.5. Just a beautiful cover. Robin cover as well. So I've got both covers, Batman and Robin, of the All-Star Batman and Robin. Okay, so we're down to my last couple of books. And this next one is just a cool book. I picked it up for 25 cents again. I got it for 25 cents. But it's Grendel War Child number 1. And this is Grendel. And it's drawn by Simon Bisley. The interiors and the story is written and drawn by Patrick McKeown. And of course, Matt Wagner did the inking for this issue. But yeah, that Simon Bisley cover is really cool. And this is a $10 book. So being able, and you know, like you can tell it's still in very high grade condition. This wasn't red. Maybe it's red, but it wasn't, you don't see like a spine bend or anything like that. So pretty clean copy. Again, a $10 book, I picked it up for 25 cents. I think I made out pretty well. Next book, Batman 686. This is an Alex Ross variant. This is about a $10 book. Just great cover. Alfred there is looking, you know, holding Batman's suit. And this is a story written by Neil Gaiman and drawn by Andy Kubert. So it's a Gaiman-Kubert collaboration on this. It's a two-parter, this one, and then it continues in Detective Comics as well. So again, this is the variant cover. I could have picked up part two and the standard cover for this, but again, you know, these are pricey books. It's like a $4 book, so half of that is still $2. But I was just happy to get this copy. I didn't feel like I need to get all three copies and pay $6 for all three. I was just happy to get this great Alex Ross variant And we also picked this one up for $2 as well, Batman 700. This is a giant size edition, Grant Morrison and a David Finch cover. And I believe Tony Daniels did the interiors. Well, the various artists did the interiors on this one. They kind of, Kubert, Finch, and Daniels all kind of worked on this book for the giant sized. Love that cover though. That's it. That's a cool cover. Yeah. This I think is a $10 to $15 book. This is high grade. It's a high grade copy. So happy to pick that up for those two up for $2. So this is Batman number 6. And this is the key issue. It's Greg Capullo cover, Greg Capullo interior, Scott Snyder story. This is the first team appearance of the Court of Owls. So it's a key book. The standard cover books at around $40, but this is the second print variant. It's in red. And again, I paid I paid $1.50. This is a $79 comic. Great pickup. Yeah. Now it's got its issues. It's got some spine ticks here along the spine, and it definitely needs a clean and a press. But as you can see, it's high grade. Even with those spine ticks, I would say this could grade grade to about a 9. Maybe it'd be an 8.5, but it's an 8.5 regardless. For a $70 book that I picked up for $2 or $1.50, I will take this all day, every day. Just so happy to pick this up. Just so happy. And that Greg Capullo cover is just amazing. Batman as an owl. That's just awesome. So yeah, like I said, this is the first full team appearance of the Court of Owls. And the second print variant cover. Just love having this in my collection. Okay, so the last one, you are really just gonna like be blown away. But yeah, I picked up Moon Knight number 3, okay? I picked it up for 25 cents. Yeah, I picked it up for 25 cents. I'm not kidding you. And it's a newsstand copy, okay? And look how clean this is. It's a black cover, but look how clean it is. Okay, it's a really, I mean, it's got a couple of spine ticks, but you can't really see them because it's, again, there's this white border here. So with a press, just press out some of these edges here. That's a really nice copy. I mean, I could see this coming back. Definitely an 8.5. I could see it coming back, possibly a 9 as well. So this has been going up because of the new Moon Knight. Again, the Moon Knight movie that's coming out. Is it a television series? Maybe it's a television series, but the Moon Knight television series that's coming. And this is the first appearance of Midnight Man. And Midnight Man is confirmed to be in that series. So we're gonna see him fight Moon Knight. I think he's gonna be the main antagonist in this series. And we'll just have to see how Moon Knight plays out. I'm just happy to get this, again, for a quarter. You know, this is close to a $100 book right here. It's gone down in price a little bit, but it's still like, you know, I'd still say in this condition, it's gonna, you can fetch about $70 to $100 for this book. So yeah, I'm just, when I saw this, I just couldn't believe my eyes. I was like, no way. this is not sitting here for, you know, 25 cents at half price books. This copy is not, and it's such a, it was in a bag and board. It was, you know, it's in great condition for, you know, 1981 book. Oh my goodness. Yeah, this is definitely the pickup of the year. Well, okay, so these two are definitely the pickups of the year. Okay, so we're talking about close to $150 value right here with just these two books. And again, I paid $16 for 31 books, including these two books here. So I think I made out pretty good. I'm feeling good about this haul. Let me know what you think about this haul. If you think I did good digging through the boxes, and I was doing some serious digging. I saw there were a lot of comic books there, new comic books I hadn't seen. So I just kind of took my time, dug through, and I found these gems, fortunately. Always, when you're digging, always kind of like have your phone ready and be looking for the keys. If you find something that you think, oh, this might have value, look it up and you'll be surprised. Like this Batman, I thought maybe this looked like it would be something that might have value. And so I looked it up and then I realized it was a $40 book. And then when I got home, I realized, hey, this is the second print and it doubled that value. So this is like a $70 to $90 book. And Moon Knight number three, this is also, you know, like a $70 book. So just so pleased with this pickup. Again, I spent under $17 for all those books. Let me know in the comments what you think of my haul. This is a long video, but I'm glad you could stick around to the end. Give this video a like if you like what I picked up, and let me know in the comments if you have similar luck at Half Price Books. I might hit the comic shop again this weekend. There's a book I've been dying to pick up. If I pick up that one book, I'll just cover it maybe in a later video. But thanks for watching, and again, not to brag or show off, but yeah, this was the fruitful results of my comic book hunt at Half Price Books. Thanks for watching.